Today on Great British Foodies, we've got something a bit different. A Greek-inspired pizza. But let me just change my hat.
What for?
Because, Adam.
Do you need a new hat? Oh.
I'm half Cypriot. So I should know what a Greek-inspired pizza tastes of.
Well, I hope so.
So today we've got Franco Manca Sourdough Pizza. Greek-inspired chicken gyros. Not gyros. If you call it gyros, I'll shout at you in the comments.
Gyros.
Adam. With garlic and mint drizzle. It says, gyro-style chicken with smoked paprika and spice. What does it say on the back? Because what are these weird things?
Well, they look like chilies. But you wouldn't have chilies on a Greek pizza. What are they, what is it?
So it says, wood-fired pizza base topped with tomato sauce, mozzarella, gyro-style pulled chicken, sun-dried tomatoes. Oh, that's what they are.
Ah, well, they look like chilies to me.
Yeah, we'll see. And garlic and mint dressing. And it says, remove all packaging, oven cook in 10 minutes, and finish with the drizzle.
Oh, look, it says there, contains one serving.
That's if you like Adam and a fatty piggy. It's actually two servings.
How long does this take? Because I'm starving. The viewers want to watch us eat it. How much is it?
How much is it? You mean 5.75 and it takes 10 minutes.
5.75?
Yeah, for this pizza.
For 5.75, I feel like I could go to Cyprus or Greece and get that myself.
Well, right.
Maybe not, but...
Let's cook it and see what we think.
10 minutes later. Shall we do a time lapse?
It's smelling good.
Oh. Oh, it does smell good. Right, pass it here. Whoa, it's going to slide. Right.
I was showing the viewers what it looked like.
Not on the floor, you're not. Right, am I cutting this?
Yes.
Right. Ooh.
Here's
right,
some
so
plate.
What are you eating? This is just for me.
No, that's for me as well.
Ooh. I need a sharper... What's it called? Pizza wheel. Is it called a pizza wheel?
Pizza cutter?
Pizza cutter. Right. So if I eat the whole thing, what we're looking at nutrition-wise, because I know these pizzas, they tend to be a bit overloaded on stuff.
Well, you'd be surprised. For half a pizza, which is approximately 235 grams, you're looking at 483 calories, which I don't think is too bad.
Am I supposed to shop on a cutting board? I think they're microplastics these days. Oh. Anyway,
if
you'd like your pizza with added microplastics, then come to our house and we'll give you it. Hopefully, we haven't got any microplastics in here. So how many calories did you say?
483 if you'd listen.
483 for the whole pizza?
No, per half pizza.
Oh, that's not bad. So
no,
I could
like
eat the full 900 pizza.
900 for the full pizza.
I'm going to do this in eighths. Smelling so good. The base is very
crisp.
Thick. It's very, I think it's the sourdough. Sourdough is usually thicker, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, it's nice and fluffy, it seems.
Ooh.
Because this sourdough is not just any sourdough, it's their signature sourdough base, made in Italy and stone-baked in the traditional wood-burning oven.
Let's see if I can show you without dropping it.
Ooh. It's not really authentically Greek,
right.
But authentic Italian, right? You're dropping it all on the table.
It is a crumb. Ooh. What do you think smell-wise first? Sniff a dog nose and all that.
So I can smell the paprika. Can't really smell the garlic.
Right, let's have a look. Let me see what's on this thing. Right.
Oh, sorry. It took me out.
Oh. Right. So we've got... Where's the ingredients?
Here.
So we've got tomato sauce, check. Mozzarella. It could do with a bit more cheese, I would say. Gyros-style pulled chicken. Okay. Sun-dried tomatoes. The sun-dried tomatoes look nothing like on that. They look massive on there.
They look very fresh there.
And with the garlic and mint dressing. Now, you've already put the dressing on.
I think on it needs more, to be honest.
You've put it on half. And
that's
it on
how
thing.
It came out.
Right, shall we give this a taste test? Because viewers want to have a go. Right, you grab a piece. Let's have a look. Right, give us your review. I'm going to grab this big slice. Ooh, with a bit of chicken. Now remember, one side of Eleanna's family is from Cyprus. So if we know that this is good, then we know it's a recommendation for our family as well to give this a try. So, whilst Eleanna is inhaling it, what do you think?
The base is nice, nice and fluffy. A lot of tomato sauce. I can't really taste...
Oh, that's good.
The spice of the chicken, though.
Oh, wow.
Are you having a food because I'm over there?
That's so good. Like, if you know me, you know that I love pizzas. But I love loaded pizzas. Oh. I'm not really getting that it's Greek, though.
I'd just say it's a meat feast with a bit of drizzle on.
So, like, right, so you're the Cypriot side, so what would they think if you went to them in Cyprus and went, I've got a Cypriot pizza or a Greek pizza, you know, and this is made in the UK, but it's from Italy, technically, but it's supposed to be Greek / Cypriot, like...
They'd think, what a load of nonsense, eat your proper Greek food.
Like, I get the infusion of it. So, wait, does this have onions on, or is that cheese?
No, that's cheese.
Is that just cheese?
Yeah.
Hmm. So what would you normally have in Gyros? Traditional Gyros in Greece or Cyprus?
So at the bottom, you'd have your zanziki, which is your Greek yogurt dip with your mint and your garlic and your cucumber.
Mm-hmm.
Then you'd have your chicken, which is traditionally cooked with, like, oregano, salt, pepper, lemon juice, some chips with some paprika, which I think is why they put the paprika on, and then your salad.
That's what it's missing.
What?
Chips.
Yeah, but you can't have chips on a pizza.
Oh, I don't know, you know. Any of the local takeaways, they know that you can put chips on pizza. Mm.
But they go soggy.
Not in the oven. Mm. But I think they're supposed to be a little bit soggy. Have another piece. What do you think?
I'd give it...
Rating out of 10, that's what we need. Rating out of 10. Only a 7? Right, tell me then, what's wrong with it? Mm.
Needs more spice. And herbs.
What spice then?
Oregano.
Mmm. Right. I would say this, as a base for a pizza, is pretty damn good. It's firm enough where it holds all your toppings. It doesn't soak into the bottom of it.
It's not really oily and greasy.
Yeah, there's no oil and grease. There's no grease on the chopping board. The dough isn't too thick where it's too
not
chewy.
Dense.
Yeah, it's not dense. It's cooked all the way through, which is good. The tomatoes are good, but I feel like it needs a little bit more tomato. There is loads of tomatoes on the picture of it.
Oh, but, you mean the sun-dried tomatoes?
Yeah, it needs more sun-dried tomatoes. The base, though, of the tomato, there's loads of that. It's very juicy.
I think
pizza.
That's a bit overpowering because I can't taste any seasoning from the chicken.
Yeah, it does overpower it because obviously it's quite acidic. Maybe they'll put some acidity regulator in.
They
I guarantee you that. Have they actually?
Acidity regulator, citric acid.
Always acidity regulator. Now, the chicken, is this made how they would make it?
Well, in Gyros, you don't pull it. You shred it from the, like, rotating kebab. If you imagine you went to a British kebab shop and you had a doner kebab, that's the kind of Gyros vibe.
What's the difference between pulling and shredding?
Well,
same thing to me.
Well, you don't pull or you don't shred the Gyros. You shave off the spit.
Ah.
So the pulled is they've got the chicken breast and they've shredded it with pieces. With them.
Let's see if I can show you. Yeah, it's like a...
Into pieces with you...
Oh. Right, it's like shredded pieces of chicken. There is quite a lot of chicken, though.
Forks. I'm going like this.
Mmm. Mmm. Oh. That. That's a 9 out of 10. Maybe even a 10 out of 10, you know. Well, genuinely, I'm not saying it's authentic, but for £5.75... I would actually buy it again, you know?
Would you?
Mm. Surprisingly, because, you know...
You're not eating this.
No, you can eat the crust. I might have some of the crust, but I just wanted to have loads of the meat. It's full of flavour. Mmm.
I think you'd do with more flavour and definitely more drizzle. Mm. Because in a chicken Gyros, you have the pita soaking up all the nice yogurt. So I think I needed a bigger sachet of drizzle.
Mmm. So, Franco Manca Greek pizza. Would you recommend?
I'd recommend, but it's not authentic. I wouldn't be telling my family in Cyprus to get this when they come to the UK.
Well, put it this way. I'm usually quite a snob when it comes to food. But I do like my bargains, right? So when it comes to pizzas, as you know, I don't like spending a lot of money on pizzas. If I can find a cheap £2 frozen pizza, I'm all over it. So to pay £5.75 for one pizza...
pretty extortionate.
It is, but it's large enough. Like, look at the box. Like, this thing's massive.
And it filled the box. It's not one of those boxes where you get a big box and a tiny pizza like this.
It is very, very filling. So, I mean, if this was on offer, it should have been on an introductory offer, you know, for like £4.
No, £3.50 club card price.
Club card prices these days are the best.
Yeah. If you don't have a club card, make sure you get one.
I would pay £5.75 for that, and that is quite unusual because I usually try and save me money, but honestly, I would buy that.
I think I'd have to get some Zanziki, though, to drizzle on the top to make it better.
And maybe some chips on the top.
No, and the side.
What if you bought this pizza with a spare pot of Zanziki, some chips, and put some...
Oh, Zanziki for you people that pronounce it wrong. It's not Tatziki.
Tatziki.
It's Zanziki. So I'll come again for you in the comments if you go, I have my gyros with Tatziki. You're wrong-uns.
Well, this has been the review. So thank you again. This is going to be the new style of videos moving forwards, basically, because there is a lot of food news, but I'd rather eat it.
You know, so would I.
I just enjoy eating.
And if you like watching us, don't forget to like, give us a thumbs up, and subscribe. So,
thanks for watching. Until the next video. Ciao.